Hey guys, it's Taylor from the Girl on Blur blog, and today I'm sharing this super easy sausage egg McMuffin. Now that we're getting into the new year and trying to forget about all the crap we ate over the holidays, I thought I'd show you how to make a healthier version of everyone's favorite breakfast sandwich. It's not an exact copycat of the one from McDonald's, but it's pretty darn close. Today we'll be using some ground turkey to make some delicious sausage patties, so you'll shave a bunch of calories off the McMuffin, and then we'll be using eggs and standard English muffins to tie it all together. Oh, and the cheese. Can't forget that. These homemade McMuffins are definitely going to be something you're going to want to make all year long, and the most amazing part of all is that they are freezer friendly. That's right, you can literally make a whole bunch of them, wrap them up, and then store them for up to 3 months in the freezer, so you can just grab one on the go to reheat if you need a quick breakfast but don't have the time to cook. I know, I'm just coming through here with the meal prep wins. Okay, so first things first, you want to get the turkey sausage patties going. If you're feeling lazy and you don't want to make the entire breakfast sandwich in one go, you should know that the turkey sausage patties are also freezer friendly. Well, duh. So you can make the patties, cook them, and then freeze them to use in all kinds of different breakfast recipes. You can use them in these McMuffins or keep them around for different types of breakfast recipes, such as breakfast burritos, breakfast pizzas, breakfast quesadillas, or even just your regular Sunday brunch. The options are endless. If you want to get creative with your breakfast sandwich, you can even switch up the toppings and add some extra veggies or use bagels as buns instead of making the standard egg McMuffin recipe. I've got a ton of easy breakfast recipes and more breakfast meal prep ideas on my blog. I've linked them below this video. So if you're looking to get your breakfast game strong, head on over. The sausage patties are made with ground turkey. Then you'll add in some salt and pepper, garlic powder, paprika, and fennel. This is my standard sausage mix, and you can use it with any type of ground meat. So if you'd rather use ground chicken or even ground pork, then go for it. Obviously with the ground pork, you'll be adding more calories because it's not as lean as ground turkey or chicken. So just make sure you're aware of that before making any substitutions. Once you've got everything mixed together, you'll form the sausage mix into patties, kind of like what you do when making burger patties, but in this case, you'll want the sausage patties to be much thinner. You'll want to aim for about 1/4 inch thickness here, as thin as you can possibly get them without them falling apart. What I find easiest is to line a baking sheet or a cutting board with some wax paper, divide the sausage mix up into 6 equally sized balls, then press down on them to flatten them. Once you have the patties made and formed into a nice looking shape, you're going to cook them. Add a bit of olive oil or whatever oil you have on hand to a large skillet, then fry the patties for about 5 minutes per side. Cook them over medium heat and watch them closely so they don't burn. I don't know about you, but I'm super guilty of getting really impatient and cranking my stove up to max heat so that the pan heats faster. It's just never a good idea. Just don't do it. Heat the skillet over medium heat and keep it there. Once your sausage patties are cooked, you'll start doing the eggs. Now here's the tricky part and where my fancy egg cup tools come in handy. I ordered these silicone egg cup rings off of Amazon. They're very cheap, like $5 or something like that. If you're not into ordering from evil corporations like Amazon, you can of course get them at most cooking stores, and many big box stores like Walmart, Canadian Tire, and Marshalls should also have them. Not that the big box stores are any better, but you get the drift. Now the skillet should still have enough grease from the sausage patties, but you can add in a bit of butter or some more olive oil if you'd like. Keep the heat on medium, then press down firmly on the egg ring to ensure that your egg will actually stay in the ring. Crack your egg into it, hold the ring there for a few more seconds until the egg starts to set, and then it's just a matter of waiting for the egg to fully cook. This should take about another 5 minutes or so. As you can see from this video, I cheaped out and I only got one egg cup ring, and that was clearly a huge mistake as I had to wait for all of the eggs to cook individually. And with 6 eggs, you just don't want to be doing that. If you don't want 6 egg cup rings kicking around either, which is understandable, then a good compromise would be getting 2 or 3 total. That way you can cook more than 1 egg at once. I tend to break the yolk of the egg after a few minutes to speed up the cooking process and keep the egg from being runny when I bite down into the sandwich, but this is just a matter of personal preference. Some people really like their runny eggs, and I'm not gonna stand in the way of that, so you do you. So now that we've got the sausage patties and eggs ready, the rest is quite simple. You'll lightly toast your English muffins. If you really wanna take the health factor over the top, you'll use whole wheat English muffins. Even though I consider myself a healthy person, I don't really eat bread that often, so when I do, I go for the white bread. But again, this is a matter of personal preference. I feel like we've already healthified this sandwich enough by swapping out the pork for turkey, so you make the final choice on the whole wheat thing. I'm not gonna push you to do more. So toast those English muffins. Hopefully your toaster isn't as erratic as mine, where it barely toasts 1 minute and then burns everything the next. Once you've got that perfect light toast on them, add a cheese slice, and please, for the love of God, make it real cheese. Then top with a sausage patty, egg, and the final top bun. Now you're in sausage egg McMuffin heaven. They really are super easy to make, and it's one of my favorite breakfast meal ideas for the freezer-friendly potential and just how filling they are. So instead of heading up the drive-thru on your way to work, you can now hit up your freezer instead. Yay! Now I know you're probably wondering how to freeze, defrost, and reheat these babies, so I will give you some quick instructions. To freeze them, you'll want to assemble them in a freezer bag, then lay them flat in the freezer once they've had the chance to cool slightly. You can either use plastic freezer bags or try to find some reusable silicone ones. The only thing with the silicone freezer bags is that they tend to be on the smaller side, so you may need to separate your McMuffins. Alternatively, you can freeze them in glass meal prep containers, but again, you'll probably only be able to fit two per container and you might risk smushing them, so use your discretion here in terms of the packaging. When you're ready to eat, you can take one out of the freezer, then pop it into the oven or microwave. I recommend the oven as the microwave will make the buns a little bit soggy. That's just something to be aware of, but the microwave works for if you're in a hurry or if you're trying to cheap out on hydro. You'll likely need 2 to 4 minutes in the microwave and 10 to 15 minutes in a 350 degree oven. And there you have it. I hope you like this video and hopefully I've inspired you to get on top of your meal prep breakfast game this year. There are so many more meal prep breakfasts where this came from, so be sure to check out below this video for the link to the full recipe along with other easy breakfast ideas. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button to get more meal prep ideas and a healthy dose of sass from me. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.